Welcome back to the Forge, guys. I'm Vulkan, and today we are taking a look at Hellgate, London, Revival, 2018 edition. That's a long title, but that's what we're looking at. Now, for those of you who don't know, Hellgate London has a rough past. They launched under Flagship Studios to horrible reception, not because of the gameplay itself, but because the systems supporting it. Billing, networking, patching, all of it was an absolute mess, and it ended up causing the game to shut down after a short life and was put on ice when Hanabitsoft bought all the rights from Flagship during their liquidation sale. Hanabitsoft relaunched the game a few years later with a heavy pay-to-win model that ultimately didn't give the game a second chance in the West, though the East actually was fairly excited to have the game back online and they still play it today. Once again, after a short life, Hellgate was shut down for a second time. But you know what they say about try number three. Hellgate London has been hit with the revival paddles and it is back to life. Hanabitsoft recently announced and launched, mind you, Hellgate on Steam for $9. Come on, guys. Really? For $9? You could have just done free to play? Whatever. That's beside the point. But the game is back in all of its nearly original glory. It is single player only though, so that is something to keep in mind. There is no multiplayer aspects, though Hanabitsoft failed to do any housekeeping on the multiplayer options, which is actually a big con of mine. There are, for instance, weapons signifying that they have mod slots, only to realize that these were the purchasable mod slots from back in the day. Silly Hanabitsoft, what are you doing? But then you also have things like, you know, disable like inspection from other players, decline guild invites, things like that that are still in the game. So it's one of two things. One, Hanabitsoft literally just went and dusted off the disc and popped it in and said, we're going to sell this. Or they plan on bringing this thing back online at some point in time. So tell your friends, tell your guildies, it might be coming back, but I wouldn't cross your fingers. We'll know probably a little bit more, I would say, in early 2019, but this is purely opinion. Do not take what I just said with any sort of clarity. It is just me making predictions. So let's get back to the actual game itself. So the game is enticing, it's entertaining, it's fun. I really enjoyed it even during the pay to win days. I enjoyed it when it originally launched, and I feel like I'm back at home. So I love playing my Evoker. And for those who don't know, an Evoker is like a mage, kind of like a caster sort. They can do quite a few different things. Just unleashing just relentless ordnance package of God knows what on the demonic horde that's trying to ravage the beautiful city of London. Watching bosses and champions, enemies just explode with loot, from unique and rare blueprints to legendary drops that kit out my caster with incredible gear, and it doesn't look too shabby either, I gotta say. So the game leans heavily on this aspect, the loot and the talent trees. Constantly improving your character by gaining skill points, gaining reputation, looking for that perfect drop, come on, legendary Cabalist Axis. But it does rely heavily on that, and you can go through dry spells of not getting anything loot-wise for a long while, only to have a champion enemy, a common enemy, maybe a blue rare enemy, explode with legendaries. It is a fantastic feeling. But there's also that feeling, that oh man feeling, because you maybe get that legendary drop you've been looking for, but it doesn't quite have those stats on it, just like any other sort of loot chaser game. Now, I hear Hellgate is always referred to as the Borderlands before Borderlands, and I will agree with that 100% because it really is. You're going around, you're looking for loot, there's so much loot, I'm constantly doing inventory management, you're breaking things down, you're crafting things, and while you might get 15 blaze pistols, they could all be different, very, very different, and play differently because of that. One might capitalize on damaging shields. One might have explosive darts that explode and then chain. One might cause lightning bolts to shoot out every so often. One of them might have toxic. You never know, and that's what makes this game fun. It's not the graphics, right? So don't get me wrong, this game is not pretty to look at. The animations and graphics are incredibly bland, and they do not catch the eye just at all. But like Project Gorgon, it's all about the gameplay. If you're interested in eye candy, I would say check out some other ARPGs like WOLCEN. WOLCEN right now is in early access. It's fantastic to look at, but it's kind of on the flip side where it has a decent chunk of gameplay, but not quite the level of loot that Hellgate has. So all in all, I've sunk about 8 hours into this game so far, and it's been thrilling. I will definitely keep playing this game and pushing my Evoker to new limits. I'm so excited to hit that level cap of, I believe, 55 is what they've raised it to. But here is my list of pros and cons. So let's start with the pros. The pros, fun gameplay. We just talked about it. It's really fun to kit out your character with different stuff, whether it's unleashing a hell swarm of missiles that just crash down on the enemy, or whether it's shooting my little harpoon gun that has explosive darts. It's all in good fun. Diverse and unique classes. This game has some of the most diverse classes I've seen. Now, they're not going to look diverse, right? I mean, you come in, you have the Guardian, sword and shield. Okay, what's the big difference? Well, once you get to a certain point, you can choose a subclass. I believe it's level 20. And that's when things start getting a little interesting. But in the same aspect, they play differently. So if you came in with a sword and shield, you might have, okay, well, he's going to be a defensive player. Probably not. Maybe there's going to be an offensive player. So there's quite a few different ways to play each class, which is phenomenal. I really enjoy it. Good job. Flagship. Hanabit, you're not getting anything. No. But flagship, good job. Tons of loot, like I talked about. Lots of stuff going on there. And then the interesting loot perks and attributes, like we talked about, you could have 15 pistols. They could all have some crazy wide spectrum of perks that would change your game style completely. But it's also a long game, guys. There is a lot of gameplay ahead of you, whether it's zones, whether it's the story, whether it's you're trying to max out all your achievements, whether you're trying to hit level cap. This is a big game. There's a lot of stuff going on. But jumping into the cons, performance at times is horrible. You'll have where your CPU will just tank. It'll shoot up to 100%. I jumped down to the sewer. It's literally just a dark gray box that has some enemies in it, and I was using my spells and things like that, and my CPU shot to 100%, and the game just started shuddering, just like a slideshow, and it was awful. That happened in two zones, but the rest of the game's been perfectly fine, so I think those zones are just sub-optimized, but that is something that made it to the list because it was quite annoying. No shared stash between characters. This is something that I'm kind of, it's weird to me that there isn't this. I'm getting a ton of legendary drops on another one of my characters, a summoner. That would have been fantastic for my marksman, but I can't transfer them, so I guess I'm just going to have to break them down. Some classes are much more powerful and interesting than others. So I start off with a summoner, absolutely horribly weak. Now, I imagine this class is going to be strong in the late game when you can summon a bunch of demons to do your bidding. But right now, you have one demon, you have like an elemental, for instance, and you don't put out just anything for damage. So you're literally just like, just unloading whatever onto the boss, and it's not doing anything. It's like, hey, why is somebody throwing pebbles at me? So you have to heavily depend on your demons, and if they die, I don't know. It wasn't a very fun class. I switched to Evoker. I'm having so much more fun. So I would say if you go Summoner, I caution you, it's going to be a big time investment before it pays off. And then the last thing is there's no UI cleanup of the multiplayer options from previous launches and their previous store options. For instance, the buy two expansion slots in the store on some gear, which makes it a little confusing because you get a drop and you're like, oh cool, it has two mod slots. In actuality, it doesn't. So that's something to keep an eye out as well. So overall, guys, I would say the game's in a pretty good spot. It just launched again. Third time's the charm. I need everybody to do some claps. But overall, I think from a single player perspective, we're going to be seeing a good game. I'm not sure what they're going to do for the future of it, but I want to hear what you guys have to say. So in the comment section below, let's get a story. Let's get a discussion going. Where do you think this game's going to go? Are you picking this game up? And is it worth it to you? Is it worth the $9 and the third time? Anyway, this has been Vulkan, guys, and I am out of here.